So children, here you can see that I have drawn a diagram of the potometer, and just hold on. And what are the peculiar things about this potometer? Let me tell you, a potometer is a device that usually measures the rate of transpiration, as well as it measures how much water is taken up by the freshly cut twig, right dear? But generally, under raw conditions, whenever the question is asked, what is a potometer, you will be defining it as an instrument which is used to measure the rate of transpiration. You never say that you are going to measure the amount of water lost, right dear? I have told you that already some water, whatever water is sucked up by the twig, some water is used by the leaves too. So in that case, your answering could not be very accurate, but your answer should be: a potometer is an instrument or a device that is used to measure the rate of transpiration, whether it is fast, it is moderate, or it is very slow, right? What are the things which are included, components of a potometer rather? You can see that there is a beaker, right? And in the beaker we have taken colored water. I'll tell you why we have taken colored water, why the setup is so, that will be taken later on, but as of now just understand the components. You can see a beaker with a colored water, then you can see a Z-shaped tube, right? Z-shaped tube. And you can see how this tube is adjusted, and in the middle of this tube where it is horizontal, you can see that we have set up a scale, right children? So this scale is having a peculiar feature. We will be discussing it later. Then you see when you move further, you see that there is a water reservoir, right? So whenever you loosen up the clip, the water is released back here. Right, so this is a water reservoir. You may be able to see some potometers where the water reservoir is not there. I'll tell you what is the benefit of having this reservoir, but as of now you just understand that it contains surplus amount of water, right children? Here the shape of the tube is slightly like a test tube. Again, the cork at the top, you have cut the cork, you have fixed the twig in, and you have reset the cork, right? Just in order to allow this freshly cut twig to undergo transpiration, right children? Now let us come to why we have taken colored water, what is the use of scale, what is the use of reservoir and all. So let us discuss them one by one. First of all, your purpose is that you have to induce an air bubble in this tube. You can see that I have used it with a different color, though air bubble doesn't have any color, but I had to use it to make things clear to you. But we have to introduce an air bubble in this tube, capillary tube. How we would be inducing this air bubble? Suppose you have kept the test tube this way and the water is streaming in continuously. Just take the test tube in the inverted form only. Suppose if it is having the head this way, you take it out of the beaker, right? Out of the water rather. Since it was completely filled with water, it will be having a kind of suction pull and the air would be entering in. And again, dip the beaker in. Dip the tube in within the beaker, right? So what did you do? You just took out this tube in the same alignment. You took it out of the water for few seconds so that an air bubble can be introduced, and again you dipped the tube in the water. This thing you can do practically at your place too. If you ever see that when you are sucking up, when you use the straw to drink a cold drink or any soft drink, you keep a straw there, right? And straw is filled with some water. You take out the straw from the cold drink and immediately dip it back. So then you'll be noticing that there is an air bubble introduced in the straw. Same phenomena is followed here too. Here the air bubble is introduced just by taking the tube in the same alignment, downward alignment, taking the tube out or lifting the tube rather, lifting the tube above the water and then dipping it back. Right, children? This is how we introduce the air bubble. Okay, then next thing. Okay, you have introduced the air bubble, your water was colored, you allowed the water to be filled here in the tube. Why there is a continuous channel in the tube? Because you have placed a freshly cut twig at one end of the Z-shaped tube. This will be losing water through transpiration. Now, since it will be losing water through transpiration, you have already understood that this is something which will be creating a suction force, right? Ascent of sap would be there, and because of this suction force, the water will gradually move ahead, right? And the source of water here is the beaker. The water source is beaker. So what did you do? You made a continuous channel. On one end you placed the fresh twig so that a continuous water column can be maintained within the test tube. You introduce the air bubble. How you have to do it, I have already told you. You introduce that air bubble. And then third thing that we did was that ultimately we have taken the water colored. We have taken the water colored. Why? The air bubble that you have introduced, you have to trace it, that how fast it is moving, right? But the thing is, within a transparent water column, you'll not be able to locate the air bubble clearly. In that case, if you make a rest of the water colored and then you introduce an air bubble would remain transparent and rest of the water column will be appearing colored to you. So it becomes very easy to locate where the air bubble is, how fast it is moving, how much distance it has covered, right dear? Now, when transpiration occurs, the water is lost through the leaves, right? The suction will be developed here. Suction will be pulling the water column further. So the water will be moving up and up and up, right? That means the air bubble which is trapped within the water column will also move further. So this is a scale which is going to measure how much distance is covered by the air bubble in how much of time. So time and distance, two things are recorded when this air bubble crosses the scale. Right? So after some time, the air bubble would reach a different location. Supposedly by after moving, it comes here. And you have noted, okay, in 5 minutes, the air bubble traveled 5 centimeters. Right? So very next time, you can compare it with, a different condition. Suppose one time you are keeping the setup in hot sun. And the other time you are keeping it under the fan. In fan also transpiration would occur. So, but the rate would be different. So you can compare, just keep it in two different conditions. See the movement of air bubble. What is the difference in the speed? Then you will be able to compare where the air bubble was moving fast and where it was moving slow or where it was moderate. Right? So the scale is to measure the distance. You can keep time record with you. You have to see the movement of air bubble. Twig is kept here as a transpiration source so that suction force can be seen. And this is how we tend to know what is the rate of transpiration and under what condition. The last thing that we have to talk about is the use of the reservoir. It's a water reservoir. I have already told you that when you release the clip, the water would come here. Right. So bubble is here. Yeah, let me use a different color so you understand better. So bubble is here. You want the same device to be used again. Right. That means you have to send the bubble back to its original place so that you, again, you can see how much distance is covered along the scale. In that case, you release this water. Water will come here. It will push the bubble back to its original place. Bubble cannot be sent further. We have to see that it has still not reached the water source through reservoir. So The moment you release it, pressure of water will thrust the bubble back to its original place. Right, children? Again, I am taking a recap. You took colored water in the beaker so that the movement of air bubble can be traced more easily. Why you have introduced an air bubble? We have introduced an air bubble because its movement will be helping us to see whether the transpiration is slow, moderate or fast. That is, rate of transpiration can be checked. Why scale is there? To cover, see the covered up distance. Why the reservoir is there? So that the bubble can be pushed back to its original place and the device can be used again. Otherwise, if the reservoir wouldn't have been there, the device could not be used again. Right, and the fresh twig here, this is the source of transpiration. I mean, it will be losing water through the leaves. And since now you know the concept of ascent of sap, the water will be moving further and further. So here there will be a suction force generated, taking the water up. Right, children? This is how a potometer works. But you do have certain limitations with the potometer. This is a Genong's potometer. Genong basically invented it. So Genong's potometer, the device is known as. But why it has certain limitations? The first thing here, it's not very easy to introduce an air bubble. A person must have skilled expertise there, right? You cannot ask a layman to come and introduce the air bubble. You should be having a proper training how to introduce it so that rest of the setup is not spoiled. So introduction of air bubble is not very easy. If you make an error, your answers would be fluctuating. Second thing is that the leafy twig that you are using, since it doesn't have roots there, it may not be acting as fresh as it is in the beginning. In the beginning it is fresh, it will show quick transpiration. The moment cell starts dying, in that case the rate of the procedure will be fluctuating because it will slow down consequently. Right, children? And the third thing here is that the setup is highly affected by weather conditions, climate conditions. The first thing is, suppose you keep the setup in sun for some time and you measure the rate of transpiration, and after an hour you keep it again in sun, but suppose two or three big clouds pass by, in that case there will be a difference because temperature will be slightly dropped. So you may have your results slightly fluctuating. They are not exactly similar every time you keep the potometer in sun. I hope this much is clear to you. So rest of the content I'll be covering in the next video.